In this video, I'm going to reveal to you the winner of the BBR award for the best astronomy binoculars of 2019, and we're going to start right now. Hello, my name is Jason, and welcome to the 2019 Best Binocular Reviews Award Winners Series. In each episode, I'll be highlighting one of the category winners and explaining just why I believe they deserve to be classed as one of the best binoculars of 2019. Now into its ninth year, the BBR Awards are a great way for me to showcase the very best binoculars, scopes, night vision devices, and accessories in a wide range of categories that I fully hands-on tested and reviewed in the past 12 months. And today we're going to be taking a look at the best binoculars for astronomy for 2019. Designed for astronomy, but also a very capable long-range terrestrial binocular, these Celestron Echelon binoculars feature a powerful 20 times magnification, as well as these really large 70mm objective lenses. So just like the windows in your house, these large lenses are able to capture and then let in much more light than smaller lenses can. However, this is just the start, because it takes much more than just large lenses to deliver bright, high-quality views, especially in low-light conditions. As what is required here is also a really good optical system, and that is where these Celestron binoculars really do excel. Scoring a 9 out of 10 for optical components on the BBR scale, these Celestron Echelon binoculars use very high-end Japanese-made optical glass and coatings to ensure that as much of the collected light as possible gets right through the entire optical pathway and onto your eyes. With such a high magnification, and for use in very low light situations, this is critical, and it is where I really notice that these completely outperform less expensive, lower quality alternatives. The quality doesn't end with the optics. Indeed, the binocular itself is assembled by hand in the US, where the focus is very much on precision and quality rather than volume. On top of this, Celestron uses an aluminium chassis on the Echelon. Whilst not as lightweight, it is certainly more robust and gives off a much better feeling of quality when compared to the many plastic polycarbonate alternatives on the market. These binoculars are also completely sealed and filled with nitrogen gas, making them both fully waterproof and fogproof. Now I know you may be thinking, astronomy doesn't really work in the rain, so what is the point of this? Well, for me, it is a strong indicator of a higher quality instrument, and on top of this, remember that these seals will also prevent tiny dust particles from entering the system. Please remember, if at any time I mention a technical term or a feature that you don't understand, or just if something isn't clear, feel free to fire off your question down in the comment section down below, and I will get back to you. Or if you prefer, just click through to the BBR website, where there are answers to most frequently asked questions. Whilst it is just about possible to use these very powerful and somewhat heavy binoculars by hand for short periods of long-range terrestrial observation, for best results, and for rock-steady, shake-free views, and something that is especially important for astronomy, mounting them onto a tripod is essential. So as you expect, these are tripod adaptable, and thus all you have to do is unscrew the dust cap located on the front face of the hinge, where it reveals a standard-sized quarter-inch thread. This thread will then accept pretty much any standard tripod adapter that you simply screw in like this. Once attached, you can then fix the adapter either directly onto your tripod or onto your tripod head, depending on what setup you have. Often somewhat misleadingly referred to as having some sort of autofocus, these Celestron Echelon binoculars use an individual eyepiece focus system, which means that once you have calibrated the instrument by adjusting each of the eyepieces to match the vision in your particular left and right eyes, no further focal adjustments are ever necessary, and everything from their minimal focus distance right to affinity will remain perfectly sharp and in focus. For long distance and astronomy, this always-in-focus optical system works particularly well and makes the binoculars much easier to use, and it is also quicker to lock onto your subject. The 19.5mm of eye relief is another impressive feature on the Celestron 20x70 Echelon binoculars and beats many of its competitors. This very long eye relief makes sure that you are able to enjoy the full image without any dark rings forming on the edges of the view, whether you wear eyeglasses or not. Another major difference between these Echelon binoculars and lower priced or lesser alternatives is the included hard carry case, which is a massive improvement on the soft case like this one that I typically see. This case is practically bomb-proof in that not only does it have a rigid construction, but like a high-quality camera case, it comes with a perfectly molded foam insert to ensure the binoculars survive even the roughest of handling. On top of this, this case has a rubber O-ring seal around the lid, and so whilst inside, these Echelons are completely protected against dust and moisture. Indeed, because it is completely sealed, there is also this cap that allows you to equalize the internal pressure when transporting the binocular between places at different altitudes. Whilst the neck strap, and especially the hard carry case, are truly excellent, I cannot say the same for the lens covers, which have to be said are very basic. To be fair to Celestron, they do fit well and work pretty much as intended, but it would have just been nicer to have had them match the very high standards set by the rest of the binocular. So what do you think about these Celestron Echelon binoculars? Do you want to, or do you actually already own a pair? Or, alternatively, do you have another pair of astronomy binoculars in mind that you thought should have won the award? I'd love to get your thoughts and opinions on this, so please feel free to comment down below. In future videos in this series, I'll be highlighting some of the other winners that include the best compact binoculars, the best travel and safari binoculars, as well as the best kids binoculars, where I do hope I'll be able to convince my 8-year-old daughter Cara to honor us with a guest appearance. So please do subscribe and remember to hit that little bell button on the side just so that you'll be notified as soon as these videos become available. This is something that also really helps both myself and my channel to continue to grow, and I really do appreciate your support on this. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again next time. Cheers for now.